are getting cold. Different kinds of faces, some young and some old. Take me down to earth.
Welcome back, sis. You look great.
Thanks. It's good to be back.
Hey, it's knocked cheers off you, that rehab, kid. Hey, maybe we should all have a go there. Hey.
Tony!
I'm really proud of you.
Yeah?
Drying out, doing the right thing by the kids. It can't have been easy.
Thanks. It wasn't. And thanks for looking after them.
Oh, here come the newlyweds.
Emma married?
She was trying to prove a point. I tried to stop her, but she wouldn't listen. I even risked my own life.
Oh, here we go.
I did. Went up in a chopper. You know how I ate flying? I was scared to death. Poor old Jim Tully. I missed the sick bag. Twice.
That's disgusting.
Things I do for my family. She doesn't appreciate it, of course. And she hardly knows him. None of us do.
Well, with your son-in-law now, you've plenty of time to get to know him.
Thanks for reminding me.
Where did you find that?
That's Hamish, one of our witnesses. It's very nice, actually. It was very romantic, wasn't it?
Not from where I was standing.
Why can't you just be happy for me? I'm glad we did what we did.
Congratulations.
Well, you've changed your tune.
Hey, she's well-trained, this one. Saved me a small fortune. A chip off the old block. Welcome to the family, son.
If you so much as hit one hair on her head, I'll knock you into next week.
Don't travel light, do you?
I'm moving out.
You didn't think of informing the landlord first?
Just thought it'd be the best thing to do. Under the circumstances.
Which are? You and me. We're adults, we can put our little fling behind us. No point sweating over it.
I'm not sweating over it.
So, what? You got yourself a spinster pad?
A cottage. Owned by Joe George, a farmer I know.
Sure you won't get lonely?
Positive.
Now, this is going to come as a massive disappointment to everyone, but the site near Glastonbury that we earmarked for our retreat has sadly fallen through. Tony, we're looking for a special sacred piece of land to rent to use as a retreat for meditations, healings, etc. But it appears that an American millionaire crystal waver has beaten us to it.
Oh, sorry to hear that.
Well, we'll keep looking. We're going to keep looking. Money's not a problem, so it just means we're going to have to find ourselves somewhere even better. Hmm? Doesn't it? Now, we don't let American millionaires get us down round here, do we? No siree. Right. Let's get started, shall we? Eyes closed, please, ladies and gentlemen. Now, let's start to synchronise our breathing. Hope no one needs to blow their nose. Now, from the stomach, please, deep breath in, hold it, and release it. Deep breath in, hold it, and release it. Right, let's start to visualize. I want you to imagine a bright, shining light, a light more radiant than any other you have ever seen before. Feel the light. Feel the light. This is your healing light. Now, keeping your breathing steady, I want you to imagine this healing light entering your body. It's just as bright and radiant as it was before. And now I want you to direct this light. The light is killing your cancer, shrinking it. The healing light is killing the cancer cells. Keep the breathing going. Keep that light on the cancer. Everything all right?
Oh, listen, Gav, thanks and all that, but I don't think sitting around here listening to other people breathe is doing me any good, you know?
Well, it's not for everyone.
Well, in fact, just sitting here makes me feel more stressed.
I understand.
Good luck in finding your retreat and all that.
Thank you. See you around.
Excuse me. I know you.
I don't think so.
You're not off the telly, are you?
No.
I've got it. Miss New Brighton, 1982.
Undisputed queen 3 years in a row.
I'll never forget a fabulous face, me.
Or figure.
You should have made it to the Nationals, what happened?
I got glandular fever snogging some guy that worked on the waltzer. Eliminated on medical grounds.
Ah, you were robbed. You've still got it, you know.
Got what?
Star quality.
Don't be daft.
No, seriously. I've got a little studio not far from here. Why don't you let me take some photos? Hey, here's my card.
I'm up to be eyes organising a birthday party at the minute. My 40th, actually.
Never. You should seriously think about that offer. There aren't many people look as good as you, believe me. And I should know.
Hi, Lynn. Didn't see you there.
Oh, I just fancy being on my own for a bit.
I'll leave you to it, then.
No, no, don't be silly. Well, I know it wasn't easy for you to take on Kate and Ryan.
They were fine once they came back from the boot camp. No, they've been great. They're a credit to their man.
I bet you did more than your fair share, what with Jackie being so wrapped up in her party.
That's Jackie.
She getting you down?
No more than usual.
Something wrong?
No.
What's up?
I've had a bit of bad news as it happens. The doctor done this test and he thinks I might have prostate cancer. So I'm waiting to hear from the hospital. They want me to go in and have a biopsy so they could confirm. Either way.
You're joking. But, I mean, you don't know yet. It could be nothing.
I could hear it in his voice, the sympathy vote.
I can't believe it. I'm really sorry. Jackie must be devastated.
I haven't told her. Happy birthday, love. Oh, by the way, I'll be dead before your next one.
Don't. You don't know for certain you've got anything.
No, no, but you can't help thinking. I've even been to one of them healing workshops, seen the leaflet in the doctors which said it might help. That's not for me. If it was as easy as positive thinking, we'd all be living to 150, wouldn't we?
You are going to have to tell Jackie.
She's got her party to organise. And I've got to concentrate on this brilliant surprise that I'm going to give her.
Great. What is it?
That's just it, isn't it? I'd be surprised if I can even think of it.
You daft thing. Well, we'd better get our thinking caps on, hadn't we?
Oh, Lynn, you will keep stum about the problem down there.
You over the threshold.
How are you really married?
I am, if you are. And now for the best bit.
Simon!
are you?
I said they could stay here while we were away.
Oh, great.
Oh, look. Fairy lights. I'll get Tony to put them up. With any luck, they'll have dodgy wiring.
That's a shocking thing to say.
Shocking for him if it happens.
He's a good man, you know.
Yeah, well, he's always skiving off when I need him.
Look, don't say I've said anything, but he's planning a surprise for you. That's why he's not been around.
Well, why didn't you tell me before?
Because it's a secret, so no more questions, okay?
Okay.
Mm. Hey, look at you in the front row. Oh, I was so jealous of you. You had every boy running after you, Miss Beauty Queen.
Oh, come on, you had your moments.
Yeah, but you were the model in the family. You should have stuck at it.
Hello? Oh, hi, Nick. Yes, well, my wonderful husband was supposed to be doing it, but surprise, surprise, he's gone AWOL. OK, I'll do what I can. Bye. First lot of booze for the party's arrived at the pub.
You can't wait till tomorrow.
Apparently it's in the way, and I've promised to help Kerry move in.
You've got the knack, haven't you?
What do you mean?
Of getting everyone else to do the hard work.
You shouldn't have.
I didn't. They were here when I arrived.
No one knock.
When a man you've never met before leaves you flowers.
What does it say on the card?
Well, there isn't one.
I think I've met this man.
Nick. Perhaps this is him trying to make amends.
What, so it's all off?
What went wrong?
Well, Ben, my ex, turning up didn't help. I sent him packing because I was interested in Nick.
Right.
But Nick isn't interested in me anymore.
Ah.
So I've moved out. I thought a bit of space might help things.
Well, plenty more fish in the sea. Though I don't know how you're going to find them. Stuck out here in the middle of nowhere.
That's the idea.
I've got to go into the village. Do you fancy coming along for the ride?
I'm busy.
Come on. It'll still be here when you get back.
I said no.
Can't you give me a chance? I'm not saying it's going to be perfect, but I need you to be on my side. I'm sober now.
Yeah, but for how long, Mum?
I don't know.
That's my point.
Sorry you got roped into shifting that lot.
No, you've done me a favour, actually. I'm not exactly popular at the moment.
How's that?
Ryan.
Don't tell me he doesn't want to go home. I thought he'd be dying to see the back of this place.
Seems like he'd rather stay here than go home with me.
Maybe he's just got to get used to the idea. Sure you don't want a drink? Sounds like you could do with one.
No, thanks.
Gonna have to lose a bit of weight, Tone. You want to sneak around and not be spotted.
Yeah, well, things just took a bit longer than anticipated.
Did they?
Yeah, and then there was a bit of a mess up and all. What's-his-face didn't turn up.
I know what's going on, Tony.
Do you?
Lynn told me.
I didn't want to worry you.
Worry me? I can't wait. I'm expecting something pretty spectacular. In fact, I'm hoping for the surprise of a lifetime.
Well, look at you.
All trussed up like a turkey. Have you got a date?
Not exactly.
Told you you'd get lonely.
And you were right.
Glass of wine, dry, lightly chilled.
Right again. I just popped by to say I'm glad we can be friends. And I hate to admit it, but you're being a lot more mature about this than me. The flowers were lovely.
Flowers? You must have a secret admirer. Told you guys he wanted to send flowers to you.
Yeah.
I need to use the phone, Barry. I've finally come up with a cracking idea for Jackie's birthday bash.
You're too good to her.
Well, I can't let her down, not for the big 4-0.
She's aged well.
Her 40th?
I'm only going to book Chris de Berg to make a personal appearance. Gonna phone his agent now, hey? Without Jackie monitoring the line.
As in Lady in Red, Chris de Berg.
Jackie loves him. Can't believe I didn't think of it before.
I'm obviously paying you too much rent. I don't want to rain on your parade, Tony, but how can you afford it?
Nothing's too expensive for my Jackie. Why, how much do you reckon?
More than you can afford.
Being considered by the government. It'll be based on what's called your...
You two, give it a rest.
She won't be long now. She's probably taking the scenic route. Ryan, will you stop that flicking?
Yeah. So tell us who you're going to be tonight, Paul. Must
control. Hey, hang on, go back one.
She's home.
4 hours later.
Been all right?
Yeah, great, love. Yeah, why shouldn't it be? You go on in and I'll be in a minute. George?
How's my lovely new tenant?
Just brought this little one back. I assume it's yours.
Everything all right, is it? With the cottage?
Yes, thank you.
Lonely old place.
Why'd you say that?
Just a bit remote, innit, for a young girl like you.
Does anyone ever go to the cottage?
Not as far as I know.
Just, I got a delivery yesterday, so someone must know where it is.
Search me.
Do you ever go up there?
Why would I want to do that? Are you blind? I've got gout, haven't I? I can't walk more than 10 yards on a good day.
I want all the serviettes folded into fan shapes, you know, like in all the good restaurants. Are you listening?
Yes, fan shapes, serviettes, right.
All the paper cups and plates need to be unpacked. Now, I know we've got them, but I think we can do without knives and forks, save them for another occasion. I want all the outside tidied up. Ryan, that's you.
Heil Hitler.
And we need to check how many bottles of homemade wine Tony's got left. Make sure he doesn't pull a fast one and try to mix it with all the good stuff. I want the whole house cleaned and dusted from top to bottom. Probably start with the bathroom.
Where are you going?
Out.
What?
To do something I should have done a long time ago. You'll have to deal with this and all.
Oh, it's the plod.
Hello.
Oh.
Come in. PC Tully, isn't it? Well, how can I help?
There was a hit and run a couple of miles from here last night.
Really?
Yeah. Luckily, the victim survived, but nevertheless, nasty business. So I'm just going round door to door, asking if anyone saw anything.
Well, we've been banged up here, slaves to my sister's party, so no. No, we haven't seen anything.
Ben.
Hey.
What are you doing here?
You thought you'd seen the last of me.
I wouldn't blame you if you never wanted to see me again.
Don't be silly. I don't hate you. There's just a few things that I thought you'd want back.
You could have thrown them.
What, you're telling me you can live without that life-size model of mating toads?
I'd forgotten about that. Do you want to come in? How'd you know I was here?
Found that guy at the pub? Your ex-landlord told me.
You don't think this is too much?
Oh, please. Like a woman of your taste could ever be too much.
Well, I do think I have a good sense of fashion.
Loving it, Jacqueline. Loving it.
Rather.
Oh, you've really got a look, you know.
Really?
Only the greats have a look, Twiggy, Shrimpton.
Did you work with them?
Oh, yeah. You know who you remind me of?
Who?
Julie Christie. In his Chivago years?
Oh, Julie Christie's nan, maybe.
So how about a bit of modelling work, then?
Well, suppose I could give it a go. What are you thinking? Classier end of the magazine market? She, good housekeeping?
Believe me, there is definitely a niche for a woman of your calibre.
I've got a lookalike. He's a fellow who does it locally. Chris De Baird, his name is. He's his doppelganger, apparently.
At a fraction of the cost?
Oh, £500 he charges. But with the house and the party and keeping a wife with the debt of a small African nation, I'm trying to raise the cash in a short space of time.
Make a day, won't it?
Make a year.
You okay?
Trying to get my hand on that money.
You could have it off me if I had it.
I know that, son.
What you need?
Someone with more money than cents.
Tony? Hello. Couldn't keep away, or are you here for the free meal?
No, I've had a pie. Suppose I shouldn't. Not exactly healthy eating, is it?
You don't have to turn into a health freak just because you're ill. So, gonna give us another shot? Door's always open.
No. I'm sorry, it's not for me. What I come to say is, that piece of land you're looking for, I might have just a ticket.
Really?
Yeah, I've no idea why I didn't mention it before.
Well, we need a place where we can relax and meditate in beautiful surroundings. Do you think it's going to be sacred enough for our purposes?
Sacred? It's like a force field.
Ooh, sounds interesting. Can I come take a look?
Anytime.
Tomorrow morning?
No problem. Just so I'm not wasting your time, I take it your idea of sacred is the same as mine.
Well, it's a very personal thing, isn't it? I always look for pagan markings. The remains of sacred oak groves are often a giveaway. But it's an ancient well that always does it for me.
Ah, yes, the sacred well. Me too.
Really?
just can't get it into my head that it's over. You did love me, didn't you?
Yes.
What happened to the other bloke?
Not a lot.
Well, if he's not around anymore, why can't we give it another go?
Ben.
Look, I'm making an effort here. Can't you meet me halfway? Didn't you like the flowers?
What? Well, why didn't you send a card?
I thought you'd throw them away.
It's over.
It doesn't have to be.
You have to respect my decision.
I don't, and I don't accept it. You're wrong about this.
Women, eh? They're sent to test us.
Same again.
And why not? You haven't got any rooms going, have you? It's a bit late to drive back now, and the mood I'm in, I might kill someone.
No problem.
Jackie, love. You're back. Have you seen Emma?
I'm building myself up for that one.
Yeah, well, we'll have to bite the bullet there, won't we? Get them over, otherwise we're never going to see you.
What, and welcome him into the fold, one big happy family?
That's the spirit, yeah.
What are you doing?
Nothing.
I'm waiting.
Well, I didn't say anything, because I don't want to jinx it, but I'm that close to clinching a deal with a bunch of hippies.
That's how Glastonbury started.
Exactly.
Well, as long as they turn up after the party.
Anyway, where have you been?
Let's just say I've got bigger fish to fry.
You scared me.
Something going on?
No. Why?
Just acting like such a weirdo.
I'm not.
Maybe not to other people, but I can tell. You get to notice these things when you live with an alcoholic.
I promise you, love, there's nothing going on. You're not worried about me.
I couldn't care less about you. It's Kate I'm worried about. She's bought into this new you, and she really wants to go home. You better not let her down.
Wow. See what I mean about the look? They've just turned out so well.
Better than I thought.
Yeah, I definitely think we should move on, miss.
You really think so?
Hmm. Tell you what I'll do, Jackie. With your permission, I'd like to show these to some contacts of mine in publishing. See what kind of response we get.
I can't believe I'm actually doing this.
What, you gone off me already?
No, I mean cooking my husband his breakfast. It's mad. Hmm.
Hey, how's it going? What's up?
I lay the table like a good little wife.
Is it? No, no, it's fine. Five? Okay, see you then. I've got to go.
What?
Well, the surf's up. You've got to get out there.
But, what, your breakfast?
Not bothered. Are you?
No.
I'll get something on the mount.
You couldn't stay away.
Gee. Nice to see you too. See, it hasn't taken Simon long to chain you to the kitchen sink.
Just trying a few things out.
Well, I won't interrupt.
You know what? Simon's just popped out surfing.
Oh, all right for some.
Come round for anything in particular?
I just wanted to check that everything was all right.
It is. Absolutely fine.
Good. I mean, it's only natural for a mother to want to know how her newlywed daughter is.
Mum, you don't even like him. It's so obvious. I don't even know why we're having this conversation.
I just wanted you to know that it's all right to admit you've made a mistake.
But that's it. I haven't.
That's good, then. As long as you're sure.
Is that it?
Your dad wants you to come over.
Well, I'm not coming on my own.
I mean both of you.
Oh, all right. I mean, I'll have to check with Simon, but I think we can make it.
Ah, great to see you, Tony.
Oh, welcome to Silverdale, or Sacreddale, as it used to be known in the days of yore.
Well, I can definitely feel something.
Can you?
Mm. The aura of the place. It's very still, isn't it?
Yeah, some people find it overwhelming. But let me show you where the sacred oak grove was before the Christians cut it down.
And how are you in yourself?
Me? I'm fine. Apart from the obvious.
Yeah.
And this is the sacred well, as documented in the Doomsday Book.
It's all right, Tony. You don't have to try the hard sell with me. I can see what's going on here.
Can you?
I think we might finally have found ourselves a home. It's quiet. It's the real deal. And you see, that's what people really need. Now, Tony, what kind of figure are we looking at?
I don't know. I haven't really thought £500. It'll all be ploughed back in to protect the land, of course.
Well, you spend it on whatever you like, Tony. I'm going to put it to the group tonight, but I have a feeling it's going to be a resounding yes.
Whatever I can do to help.
I tell you, you hardly even notice we're here. You see, all we want is to experience a totally natural environment with no interference from the outside world whatsoever.
Of course.
This place is going to work. We'll be able to open our minds and allow our spiritual side to develop and hopefully heal ourselves from within. I'm impressed.
I thought you would be.
No, with you, I mean. During such a difficult time, you've still found the time to think of other people, and that takes great courage, Tony. Great, great courage. Well done, you.
I know I said you'd miss me, but I never expected this.
Don't flatter yourself. I just don't like living in the middle of nowhere, that's all.
Ah, you've come back to make up.
What are you talking about?
Benty. I'm sure he'd let you bunk up with him.
Ben's staying here.
You could make a saving on the rent.
I don't understand why he hasn't left yet. He won't take no for an answer. I wish he'd just go.
Must be the effect you have on men.
Very funny. Never seen him like this. It's weird, but last night... Did Ben leave the pub after I'd gone?
Don't know, why?
I'm probably going mad, but I thought someone was in the house.
Do you want me to come over and check it out?
No, thanks. Must be me. I'm losing it.
Not every day your only daughter gets hitched. I know you didn't do it in quite the normal way. Your mother would have loved to have got dolled up, and I would have loved an excuse to have sank a few pints. Anyway, here we are, and well, it means a lot. I mean, none of us know exactly how much longer we're going to be around.
Dad?
No, I know it sounds soft, and I know Emma can look after herself. I'd just like to know that she was in safe hands.
He's not normally like this.
No, it's fine, Emma. We are young to get married, and I understand where your dad's coming from.
So have you got plans of some sort?
I've got a college course lined up, and then I'll be going into my uncle's boat-building business. Once we get a salary and Emma sorts out what kind of career she'll be going into, we'd like to get our own place, wouldn't we?
Yeah.
What's that?
All that stuff he said to my dad about our future and that. It's really nice.
Oh, you're off your head. It's just what you say. Keep the oldies quiet, isn't it?
Oh. Who is it?
It's Nick. Can I have a word? You're lucky I found it before Kerry did.
I don't know what you're talking about.
Really? Because someone with your credit card, fitting your description, paid for it.
It's none of your business.
Kerry's a mate. I'm making it my business.
And I know her. And it's only a matter of time before she comes round to my way of thinking. Anyway, what do you care?
I think Kerry can make up her own mind about who she wants to be with.
It was you, wasn't it? You're the one she dumped me for.
I don't know what you're on about.
Would she want to ride in there and save the day like the big macho man? I would be with Kerry now if it wasn't for you.
I'm warning you. If you go near, or even look at her, it'll be you needs one of those.
Oh. Right. Today is D-Day, which means that nobody leaves without permission of yours truly. I want all hands to the pump, no one wimping out.
No chance of that.
Yes? Hello, Trevor. I just didn't expect to hear from you so soon. Really? Wow. You charmer, Trevor. Of course I can make it. And thanks again. Bye. Right. I'm going out.
Again, what happened to no one leaves on pain of death?
Lynn, I've got a photo shoot. Looks like my modelling career might be taking off sooner than I hoped. Tony, there's a hippie in the garden.
That's my man. All right, mate. This is unexpected.
Hope you don't mind me turning up like this, Tony.
No, not at all. Do you fancy another look round?
Oh, no, no, that won't be necessary.
What, you've made your minds up?
Yes. It's perfect.
The whole lot.
It gives the group a bit of hope, knowing that there's somewhere sacred and restful they can come. Oh, Marianne would have loved it. She lost the fight last night. 31.
I can't take this.
Why not?
I should never have asked for it. I was trying to make a fast buck out of people who were dying. There's nothing sacred about this land.
I see.
The truth is, I was strapped and I wanted the money too. To pay for the Christaberg lookalike for my wife's party tonight.
A lookalike?
That's me. One of life's fakes.
So. I'll let you know which magazines I'm going to be in. Probably get them here anyway. Just think, I'll be your first celebrity client. And if the salon wanted to, you know, use my name for publicity or anything, I'm sure we could come to some sort of arrangement.
Just, and I'm sorry. Yeah, well, it hasn't exactly made my day either. Well, you can tell Mr. De Baird from me that sometimes life doesn't go to plan. Sometimes it deals you a crap hand. And there's nothing you can do except grin and bear it.
Dad?
Hello, love. Didn't hear you come in.
Is everything all right?
Yeah. Nothing your old dad can't handle.
Hey, you all right? How are you doing?
Not bad.
How's married life?
Yeah, great.
Not that good, eh? Mm. I can't believe you married him that quick.
Yeah, well.
So?
Look, don't tell anyone this, all right? Especially not Mum and Dad, but... Well, I think I've made a big mistake, and I need you to help me get out of it.
Right. Okay. Have you consummated the marriage?
What?
You know, done it.
It's the one thing he's good at.
Right. 2 years.
2 years? Mm-hmm. Ryan, I cannot be married another 2 years.
Right. There is a quicker way out.
Go on.
If one of you has an affair.
And on the night in question, you weren't aware of anyone getting into their car over the limit.
What do you want me to do? Stand at the door with a breathalyzer?
You're the copper, and you're the landlord, so maybe you could help me out here?
The only thing that I can think of is... But I'm not very sure of my facts, so...
I've got a witness says they saw a car leaving the Black Bull minutes before the incident. So, can you remember who was in that evening?
What? Off the top of your head?
In your own time.
Right, Nick, come to help us.
Oh, no.
Who are you after?
Actually, it was you I came to see.
Oh, what a nice surprise. Why don't you go in and give your Uncle Tony a hand?
I'm talking to Nick.
In, please, Kate.
It's about the hit and run the other night.
Oh, that? I've forgotten all about it. How awful of me.
Well, I thought I should let you know I've given your name to the police.
All right. Why?
Tully insisted I tell him everyone who'd been to the pub that night.
But I told you I didn't see anything. I don't know anything about it.
I'm just letting you know. If you haven't seen anything, you've got nothing to worry about, have you?
No. Couldn't you find your Uncle Tony?
No. What did Nick want?
Nothing really. About the booze for Auntie Jackie's party.
No, it wasn't. It was about the hit and run.
Well, that as well, but as I said to Nick, I know nothing.
You're lying.
No, I'm not.
I saw you that night when you came back. I saw you check the front of your car. Then you came into the kitchen. You had a drink, didn't you?
No, I didn't.
Why can't you just tell the truth?
Because I can't. Because if I come clean, I could go to prison, and you don't want to see your mother go to prison, do you?
No. Can't you just tell him you did it, and you're sorry, and it wasn't your fault?
No.
If it was an accident, I'm sure they'd understand.
They wouldn't.
I'm not leaving till you tell me what's wrong.
It's nothing.
You were all right until Mum tipped up. What was going on with Nick?
I don't know.
You don't have to lie to me.
It was Mum who did the hit and run. She started drinking again. Please don't tell anyone. Where are you going? Please, Ryan, don't you ruin everything.
It's not me ruining everything.
Just leave it.
That's stupid. I'll get you out.
Ryan!
Didn't I tell you not to let her down?
Yeah.
I'm okay.
We wanted to go back home. We wanted to be with her mates in Nottingham. We didn't want to be here in the first place. Don't you get it?
I made a mistake.
Knocking someone over and leaving him for dead. Or trying to get my little sister to lie for you.
I can't help it. Please.
Oh, please. You can help it, Mum. All your life has been someone else's fault. No one forces you to drink.
I know. I'm sorry.
No, stop it. We've heard it all before. If you were really sorry, if you really wanted to start again, then you'd prove it. You'd do the right thing for the first time and you're excused for a life.
Perfect. Just what the readers go for.
Thanks.
Great. So let's get busy.
I'm ready.
Right. Well, so go on then.
Go on what?
Well, get them off.
I beg your pardon?
Trevor did explain the job.
Yeah?
That this is glamour work.
Glamour?
Yeah, you know, like double D's for the over 50s. Sells like hotcakes.
Tony.
Didn't expect to see you again. What's this?
It's Chris de Burgh's piano.
Oh, get away.
No, no. 100% genuine, bona fide article.
Well, what's it doing here? Careful there, mate.
Hello. Nice to meet you.
Blimey! I must be dreaming.
Chris and I went to college together.
Stupid hunky cow.
I'm in the bath.
Nothing I haven't seen before. Happy birthday, love.
Is it a knockoff?
Oh, no. Thought you might wear it tonight.
Whatever it is, I forgive you.
What's that?
Well, you've obviously done something, otherwise you wouldn't go to this much effort.
No. I just wanted to make you happy before it's too late.
What do you mean, before it's too late? Too late for what? To help clean up?
Well, Tony asked me. I brought you this.
Oh.
I put a bit of extra sherry in it, seeing as it's your 40th.
Why don't you help yourself to a drink, Vi? Seeing as you're here.
Now, the sausages on the stick in case you're a bit peckish. Nice little selection of drinks there, OK. Now, if there's anything else you want, because I know you rock stars have got fussy tastes, haven't you? Just see my man Ryan over there, OK? Promise me you'll do that?
Sure, no problem.
And by the way, I'll get the banjo out separately and we could do a little bit of an old duet, eh? See, that's all.
Can't wait. Looking fabulous, Jackie. Not that I'd expect anything less.
Thank you, Nick. Tony bought it for me. Beats his usual efforts.
A little bird tells me you're doing a spot on modelling.
Well, you know, life begins at 40 and all that. Here you go, Jackie.
Thank you. Simon, Joe, Simon. Pleased to meet you at last. Has Emma told you about my new hobby?
No.
Pole dancing.
Really?
Keeps you supple in all the right places.
The piano's behind there, so when I give the signal, pull the curtains away. De Burgh will do the rest. He's a complete pro.
So what's the signal?
I'll get them all to stop yabbering so they can hear you. Then there'll be complete silence.
Oh, okay.
Oh, and if you would be so kind, will you play something that'll get everyone shaking their leg?
Sex Bomb or Disco Inferno.
I thought your mum would be here.
We fell out earlier. Don't know where she is.
Oh. I'm sure she'll turn up soon.
Why don't you two have a dance?
Are you sure?
I'll show you how supple I am.
I just wanted to tell my wife how incredibly, fantastically wonderful she looks.
Mm-hmm. You after something?
No. Well, just to know that you're enjoying yourself.
Yes, I am, actually. No thanks to you.
Well, I must admit, I haven't been quite as hands-on about your party as I would like to have been, but
I don't think you'll be disappointed.
You dancing?
Not in these shoes.
It's a party, Kerry. You're supposed to be enjoying yourself. Your room's free again, if you want it.
Really? Where's Ben?
Dunno, he left.
Where did he go?
Didn't bother asking. He's in a bit of a hurry.
Did you kick him out?
Would I do that? Come on, how about this dance? Come and help me ignite. Love struggle holding you tight. Hold me tight, dog. Make me explode. Although you know the route to go to sex me slow. Is that what I think it is?
Operation Quickie Divorce. I think I've had a little bit too much to drink.
Shall I go and get Emma?
Oh, no, I just need to go and lie down, I think. Will you take me upstairs? You're my sex bomb. And baby, you can turn me on. Turn me on, y'all. Sex bomb, sex bomb. You're my sex bomb. Can't give it to me when I need to come along. Sex bomb, sex bomb. I just need a bit of a lie down. Will you help me?
Excuse me!
Dad!
Will you take your hands off my son-in-law?
What do you think you're doing?
What am I doing? I'm only trying to save your marriage. Your so-called best friend was trying to seduce your husband.
What, did they do anything?
No, I got here just in time.
Why can't you just keep your nose out? What have you done?
Nothing. Emma, what's going on?
I planned it. Planned what?
I caught Simon and Airmate about him, you know.
Why? Because you were right. I made a mistake. I should never have married him.
Trouble at 9 o'clock. Right. Let's get you in here before Goldie sees you.
Yes, let's all worry about Ryan and Kate. No one worries about Lynn. I did the right thing for once in my life. It was me who knocked down that farmer and I could have killed him. But I've just handed myself in to the police for the sake of my kids. Because I love my kids. I know I've fallen off the wagon, but I admit it, so please don't make out I'm a bad person.
Lynn, don't go making a show of yourself.
Don't patronise me. I'm not having that from you of all people.
Let's make you a nice cup of coffee.
It's about time she heard the truth. What truth?
You're so wrapped up in yourself, you don't even know your own husband's terrified he might be dying of cancer.
I've never seen you looking so lovely as you did tonight. Never seen you shine so bright.
Dad?
It's not true. Tell me it's not true.
All the highlights in your hair that catch your eyes. I have been blind. The lady.
Tony, tell me this isn't true.
It's not confirmed.
What does that mean?
It means I don't know. You want me to go for a biopsy, but I can't. I know I've got to check. I just know I have.
You've got to find out.
I've got all the symptoms. It's just a matter of confirmation. I don't want to know.
But Tony, it might be nothing. How long have you known?
A couple of weeks.
And you didn't tell me?
I didn't want to ruin your birthday, did I? I wanted this to be the best ever party.
Oh, Tony.
Jackie, you've got your life in front of you with your modelling and everything.
The modelling isn't going to happen. I was conned. You should have told me.
I just wanted to make things up to you.
What things?
I don't know anything. Everything I do is wrong, isn't it? I end up being worse off than when I started. I just wanted this time to be right.
Tony, I don't care.
Don't you?
All I care about is, you know, you. We're gonna go for the biopsy.
I'm scared.
I know. But we're gonna go. And whatever the result, then we'll face it together.
Everything's gonna be all right, love, isn't it?
Got a feeling we might be staying around here a bit longer. You okay with that?
What about you?
Yeah, I am if you are.
I never will forget the way you look tonight.
A Christa Berg lookalike, he's bloody good.
Hey, Jackie.
Arriba! Arriba!
You don't go around accusing other people's kids of being a bad influence when you don't even know them.
But you said yourself they've been bunking off. Now, Kate is not the kind of girl who'd do that if someone
Were you ever a child?
Yes. And apparently you still are.
For as long as I know how to love, I know I'll stay alive. I've got all my love to give. I've got all my love to live. I will survive. I will survive. Hey, hey.
What's going on now?
They would, Donny.
I can't do this.
You're a natural.
Bloody Sam.